In this class, let us discuss another problem on voltage regulators. So here in this problem, fixed VI input is fixed, but variable RL. RL will be variable. Now let us see the example here. So this is a Jenner diode network with 30 volts and input resistance is 2 kilo ohm Jenner diode. And here PZ maximum, that is maximum power dissipation of the Jenner diode, is 8 milliwatts. This is RL. So here the question is, for the Jenner diode network shown, determine the range of RL and IL that will result in VRL being maintained at 10 volts. So VRL, that is voltage across RL, it should be maintained at 10 volts. So this voltage should be maintained at 10 volts. So meaning is the VZ is 10 volts. So we can understand VZ is equal to 10 volts. And here, how to find the range of RL here? So for this, we have a relation. Observe, this voltage is fixed at 10 volts. When this voltage is exactly 10 volts, so here IL, I we can calculate is, so the I we can calculate is the voltage across this one is, I is equal to, so 30 minus 10 divided by 2 kilo ohms. So that will result in, so this is 20 by 2, so that is 10 milliamperes. So this 10 milliamperes is fixed here. So this 10 milliamperes, some current will enter into Jenner, some current will enter into resistance. So here we can, by taking a loop equation, by taking the KCL at this point, we can take it as I is equal to IZ plus IL, that is load current. IZ plus some Jenner current and load current. So here, when you take maximum current across the Jenner, when you take maximum current across Jenner, so we can take the relation IZ maximum. So when you take IZ is maximum, at that point IL is minimum, that is IL is minimum. So when you take IL is minimum, then so here least current, that means maximum resistance, that means RL is maximum in this case. And similarly, when you take IZ is minimum, let us take least current here, IZ is minimum. So when you take IZ is minimum, then IL is maximum. So your maximum current will enter into this one. IL is maximum. So when you take maximum current here, then RL is minimum. So here how to, let us start with the first condition, IZ maximum. How you will find IZ maximum here? According to this relation, first we got PZ maximum is given, that is maximum power dissipation is given. So once you know the maximum power dissipation in the Jenner diode, we can calculate the maximum current, because already we have VZ here. So when you take PZ maximum we got, that is 8 milliwatts. So from this we can find out IZ maximum. So IZ maximum is PZ by VZ, that will result in 8 milliwatts by 10 volts, that is equal to 8 milliamperes. That means here in the IZ, in this case, total 8 milliamperes are going through, are entering into Jenner diode. So here this is 10 milliamperes, 8 milliamperes are going here. So what is the resultant in the RL? This will become 2 milliamperes. So here, when you take IZ maximum, so IZ maximum is, I am taking 8 milliamperes. So when IZ maximum is 8 milliamperes, then IL minimum is 2 milliamperes. 2 milliamperes is IZ minimum. So what is the RL minimum? RL maximum is, so here the voltage across this one is, the voltage across this resistance is VZ, that is VRL or VZ, both are 10 volts, divided by IL minimum. So this will result in, this is 10 divided by 2 milliamperes will result in 5 kilo ohm. That is the maximum RL we can use. And how to find out minimum RL? So for minimum RL, we have to find out IL maximum. So then we need to know what is the IZ minimum. So what is the IZ minimum here? Normally in the some statements, they will give what is the minimum IZ here. But in this statement, IZ minimum is not given. So what we consider is, the total current in this resistance will enter into load only. So that means no current enters into Jenner. Jenner will be in the breakdown region, it will be open circuit, it will act as a regulator, but here the current I am considering as 0, so total current will enter into load only. So in that case IZ minimum I am taking as 0 milliamperes. So when you take IZ as 0, so the total current 10 milliamperes will enter into load. So that is 10 milliamperes will enter into the load. So when you take 10 milliamperes as IL, then this will be equal to V RL divided by IL maximum. So when you take IL maximum, this is 10, input is 10 volts divided by 10 milliamperes. So that will result in 1 kilo ohm. So here from this calculation we can understand the range of IL is, so the range of IL will range from minimum is 2 milliamperes to the maximum of 10 milliamperes. And similarly RL is having the range, RL minimum is 1 kilo ohm, RL maximum is 5 kilo ohm. So here this is 1 kilo ohm to 5 kilo ohm. That is the range of IL as well as range of RL. And here we should understand one point. When you take minimum load current, when you take minimum load resistance, then maximum current. So when you take maximum load resistance, then minimum current. So this 1 kilo ohm corresponds to this 10 ohms, this 5 will corresponds to 2 milliamperes. That is the range of IL and as well as range of RL for the circuit. This is the answer for this problem.